Welcome to the vlog. Welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new here, I'm Atharva, and today we're gonna be reviewing the Nerf Raptor Strike. So actually, we will start the introduction from the parts. Okay, so we're gonna see the first part over here, which is the bipod. It is used for it is connected here. Because it has a tactical rail also, and it is used because to set the gun properly on the ground. So it has these extendable, you know, legs kind of thing. See, it has these extendable legs, and it has full 360 degree rotation. So, and you can connect this bipod to any other Nerf gun also. You get this with the Raptor Strike actually. So you have this, and for putting back in the extenders, you can actually press these buttons. So you can have to press this button and then take it back in. Press this button and take it back. This is done. This is the bipod, okay? Let's move to the magazine. So this is the magazine 1, which goes over here, and it has 6 bullets, okay? It has 6 bullets. It's the magazine 1, which goes in first. Then you have the bolt, okay? This is the bolt, which is actually used for reloading the gun. So if you know, you have shot one bullet, so you use to put it here, you fix it, and then you do it front and back, then it's one time it's loaded. So this is the bolt, and then this is the, you know, the proper AccuStrike darts, these orange one which has the gray head and the orange body, the other part. Then we come to this dart. So this is actually the Nerf Modulus dart, the white one, glow in the dark. Okay, so this is the Modulus dart. It can, you know, the Elite dart, okay, so the blue color Elite dart is also same like this. The shape and all is same, but only the color is different. So, you know, you can consider this as the Elite dart also. Let's move over here. This is the mag 2. So the magazine 2, it is stored over here in the back. Just, you know, put it here. So if your one of your magazine is over, you can just pull it out and, you know, put it back here. So the parts, you know, some of them are done. Now we'll move over here. This thing is the access door. Okay, so we have the access door over here. So this thing is the access door. We open it, you know, like this. So if there is any, you know, bullet getting stuck over there, you can put your finger like this into it, and you can, you know, make space and you can fix it. So actually,
start.
So actually, you can put a finger in here. You can see I've not put the magazine, but you can put a finger in here and then you can fix it. It's a spring powered magazine fed blaster. It's an access door over here, and then you have the pop up sight. You have the button over here. You know, if you do this, so you have, you know, many arrows like this, and they aim over here. So, you know, if you are like, you know, like this, then you can also see, you can get a, you know, precise aiming. So if you're aiming at that, you can see that this arrow, huh, that it will go over there. So this is the pop-up sight. In total, this is the pop-up sight, which you can see here. And now it's actually, this is the trigger here. Okay, so when you are, you know, done loading it, so you can shoot with this. Then this is, you know, this button is actually for the magazine. So you pull back the reloader, then the magazine, you know, the lock will get unlocked, and then you can press this button, so it will come out like this. I'm going to show you. Magazine 1, you put it like this, and then you can press this button, take it out, okay? So that is the way it works. Now let's go for the joining part. So we have to join it all, the assembly part. So, you know, let's go. We have actually this thing. We will do it afterwards. We have this thing first. So how to do it is, you have to, you know, you have a small hole over here. If you look and know, you have a small hole. You can put through this like this, and then there's it comes out from the second side. Then you have to fix this to this. You have to, you know, just roll it, make it a little tight, so, you know, it doesn't come out easily like this one. So I've made, you know, enough tight. Now, you know, we can use it to shoot like this. Did you hear it? So this is how it works. Now we are going to actually do the both firing tests. First firing test is of this, then is the Modulus darts. So let's go for this, the magazine first. So we're gonna fill bullets in there. One, there's a standard magazine for the, you know, AccuStrike, Raptor Strike. 6 darts in each magazine. So we're gonna put 6 dots in there, like this. The 5th dot and the 6th dot goes here. So this is done. Now let's put this over here. First we have to take it behind, because then otherwise, you know, there's a lock over here, so it doesn't get unlocked. So you have this, just feed it in there. Yeah, that click sound means it's done over there. Let's feed the darts of the modulus into this. So we'll do the both firing tests and see which works better in here, if it, you know, gets stuck and all. So let's see. We have got the standard modulus darts here. There are also 6 in the second mag, which is the bonus mag over here. So we put it at the back over here, the extra mag, and finally the bipod. Okay, so we're gonna, first of all, you know, we're gonna use the bipod actually. Let's try one shot and use it. So we have it, and we can do like this over here actually. So you have it over here. Now you can keep it like this. It's done. So now we go to the shooting part. We're gonna shoot it over there. So first we are gonna shoot it without the bipod over here. See, you can use this thing. Okay, pretty cool. That's all, okay. So now we have to actually pull this back. Then we have to take this out. So we have this button over here. We'll take it out, keep it here. Then take the modulus darts. So now we put it in here. Click in. Now we're gonna do with bipod test. So we're gonna extend it to max. Like this. And then we're gonna shoot it. Okay, we have to, this mag can go behind right now. In 3, you got the side. 2, 1. So now we have it. So it actually, this is a very nice gun. It's one of the longest Nerf guns in the world. One of, okay, I don't know which is this, but this is pretty cool. You can fold it like this. Then you can remove it like this. You can pull out the mag. You have the button here. And pull out the mag. Okay, this is, there's no button over here. Now you must be asking that, is there any button? But there's no button. You can just pull it out. Okay, so it's done. And you can shoot this. But there's one more thing. Here is the reset button. So this is a small button, you can see. This is a reset button. So you can lock it like here. Okay, so that it doesn't go there. Actually, it works like that. And then you have one more button over here. I don't know what is this button, but I guess they just put it. Like it locks, I guess. Like here. Yeah, it locks it. This button locks the thing. And then you can shoot it. This, and here is the normal aiming, which we have the sight. Now let's go and find our darts here. So guys, I got my darts back, and actually the AccuStrike darts worked better in this gun, because obviously it's an AccuStrike gun, so they will work better. But you know, in some guns, even if they are Elite or AccuStrike, other types of darts, you know, work better for them. So let's go with this. So actually what happened with these is, you know, they went really slow. I don't know why, but I checked it out, and you know, the speed was little slow, I guess, because it didn't rebound back. So you know, these, you know, came halfway through, these AccuStrike ones. These, you know, they banged the door over there, so as the target, and they came halfway through, so the power was very great in this. And finally, I actually want to say that this is the rubber grip, which is very cool in, you know, some guns like the AccuStrike Falcon Fire. You don't have the rubber grip, you have the plastic one. And I recommend that don't use crummy darts, like, you know, the non-Nerf ones. Like, these are Nerf darts, this and this one. So these both are Nerf darts, so they actually work well. And don't use crummy darts, so you know, the non-Nerf actually, so they are, you know, some other company, and they are very soft, you know. Don't use that, because you know what happens is, sometimes they are, you know, too soft, so they get stuck because of the fast, you know, the rapid fire in this. So yeah, they get stuck in there, and you know, then there's a problem. The dart breaks, and there's a lot of problem in there because this is spring power magazine fed blaster. So you know, I recommend don't use crummy darts, because I once used it, and then you know, the dart broke over here because you have that, you know, latch kind of thing here, so it broke over there. And it's a very good experience with this. You get, like, you know, the sniper feel in this. And the bad news is that even if you get the sniper feel kind of thing, you don't have the tactical radio. See, I'll show you one thing. Here is the... Now you can see this thing. This thing is for the tactical rail. You can see this rail going on. You have this, you know, latch kind of thing once more. See, you can... So there is a rail here for the bipod, but there is no rail over here. Can you see? There is no rail here. Literally, that's the bad news. I was thinking, you know, the bioscope and put it on the tactical strike. It would look cool, but you know, I bought it and put on the Alpha Hawk. So then I later gave it to my brother, and so then, you know, it looked cool on the Alpha Hawk. But I thought it could look even more cooler. I just tried to keep it. So you don't have any tactical rail over here. Instead of the tactical rail, you have this pop-up thing, which is, you know, this also has a spring. But sometimes this can also come out. I've experienced it, you know, when I had a battle with my brother. So with my brother, but with my friends also. So the Nerf battle video, the very old one on 31st December 2019. So you know, what happened is my friend, you know, he crashed into me, and because of the crashing, this broke. So you know, then I fixed it again. You can fix it, you know, you can, you know, just install it back over here. So really, it's a very good gun, but if you don't use it properly, then it will not happen, it will not work. So you know, this is a very good gun. It has, you know, these darts work on this one for 66 speed. It's the range. And these work, you know, around 405 feet or 90 feet. Yeah. Yes, so you know, there's a range difference, but you know, the power, it is more in this dart. So, the review is done. Thanks for watching this video. Make sure to subscribe and like to my channel. And comment down below if you think I should do more videos of unboxing or reviewing these guns. So, bye.